Another touch point that a designer is going to absolutely love is the registration form. Event registration is, after all, the main goal of your event page, right? Well, Splash not only grants our users the ability to fully customize the way that their registration form looks, but we also give you the chance to decide on what types of questions you're asking and even allow you to revise any messaging on the form to fit your brand's voice. It's honestly one of my favorite parts of the tool, so let's check it out. We will first click into the registration form touchpoint from the event overview screen. As the workspace loads in, you'll find that it is similar in navigational setup to the event page and the share card workspace. The top bar allows you to navigate back to the event overview, preview the form, and save changes at any time. The right-hand side gives you two options, questions and style. The questions tab is fairly straightforward. You can reorder questions, add questions, delete questions, and fully customize the content of each one. Splash offers a really amazing array of out-of-the-box questions to choose from, but you also have the ability to create completely new ones. Also, once you create a custom question, you always have the ability to save it to keep it in your account forever and use it on any future event. Once saved, they'll be stored in My Questions portion of the Questions modal. Once you have your questions set, let's get into the fun part, the Style panel. The Style panel allows you to quickly access and customize the entirety of your form, the main headline, the form fields, the Submit button, and even your error messaging. Let's break down each accordion tab. Inside the form accordion, your first choice is to decide whether you want your form to pop up as a standard modal, slide out from either side of the page as a panel, or take up the entirety of the screen. Experiment with these options. I especially like the look and feel of the panel, and it's neat that you can choose which side the form will slide out from. Also inside the form accordion are your quick spacing options. You can elect to revise the spacing of the entirety of your form to be tight, standard, or loose. Advanced designers that need more creative control can click into the custom cog wheel and make even more granular changes. The background of the form can also be adjusted to be a different color from your color palette, or even be a background image. I find most background images to be a bit busy, but if you can find a really simple abstract texture, that could look really sweet. More likely than not, you'll want to keep the close button in some gray or middle tone color value, but feel free to change it to a different color in your palette as well. Next step, the headline tab. Clicking into here will allow you to adjust the font, size, color, and alignment of the main headline in the form. Once that is set, take a look at the image option. A designer can elect to include a banner image at the top of the form or have it display in a more contained space, which we refer to as logo. If you select logo, you have further options for what size you want the logo to be. The form fields tab is pretty fun too. You can enhance the overall user interface by changing how the question text looks like above the input fields. If you have helper text, you can style that here as well. The input text is usually pretty important. It's best practice to choose a lighter color for placeholder text that is legible enough to direct the attendee on what to enter, but also doesn't stand out and make it seem like the field has already been pre-populated. The color of the answer text should be your darkest color in your palette, or whatever the opposite of the background color of your input background is, which you can edit below. The borders of your input fields can be customized too. We give the designer quick options for the thickness of the border via this drop-down menu, but advanced designers can click into the advanced cogwheel and further enhance the border thickness, radius, and even decide if they want to have the border on all sides or not. For this demo, I'll only apply a border to the bottom of the input and set the radius to 0. One quick note about the form fields tab. Don't sleep on those hover states. You can quickly improve the experience for your attendees just by simply applying some color-changing hover states to all your form fields. Fun, right? The next tab down is the button. We give you the chance to make your submit button as on-brand as you had it in your main call to action button for your event page. The button's copy can be edited from the question panel back at the top of the screen if you want your button to say something different than the default submit. Last step, decide if you want your button to be aligned left, center, or to the right. Perfect, this looks great. The last portion of the form a designer can customize is the error messaging. Sometimes that red error message is too jarring. Feel free to edit the color and the font here. Once you're finished, be sure to hit save and click the back button to navigate back to the event overview.